Great stuff. Let's do some exercises just to remind ourselves that we are not dealing here with algebra. You might be asked just to solve for x there. I have ax and b equals c. And then for all a, b, c, x elements of this group, and I'm going to write group like this with these little brackets, the group. So that's all the elements, all the elements in the set G and the operation on those. Now, just want to remind you, I mean, if we look at ax, b, we could say, well, we could just say, in normal algebra, I was just going to say that c equals a, c equals x equals c is a over b, or x equals, I mean, I could write this as c, or, you know, bring it up the other side so that c a inverse b inverse. But that would just suggest that these are numbers, and they're not. This is not representative. The elements here are not representative of numbers. If these were, for instance, square matrices, I won't have that. We do not have this commutative property. So remember, we have closure. So if this group operation, if I apply that to any two elements in the set, the solution must also be there. I have associativity, I have identity, element. And then for every element, I have its inverse, also in that set. No way that, does it say commutivity there. So just beware when you do this. So what I'm going to do here is say A inverse A X B equals A inverse C. A inverse, I'm going to use my associative property, that just gives me the identity element, so that disappears. I can have X B and B inverse, meaning I have A inverse C B inverse. That associativity, that gives me the identity element, so I have X equals A inverse C B inverse. And if these were anything, these can now be any elements, for instance, square matrices. If I did them in this order, I'm going to get a solution to x. Otherwise, I would not have gotten a solution to x if I just saw this as normal algebra. So please, please, please remember those. Let's do some more so we can get used to this idea. So let's have a look at this problem. Now, try and get some of these online or in your textbook. They really are fun to do, just to get your mind around working with groups. When I write x squared there, remember, I have my group, and I have multiplication is my operation here. So when I have x squared, I actually mean x and x. So I have this fact that if I do that, the group operation on two of the same element, that gives me b, and if I do it five times, I get e. In other words, what I'm suggesting here is x and x equals b, and what I have here is x times x times x times x times x equals the identity element e. So for two of those x's, I could put a b. For two of those x's, I could put a b, and there I have an x, and that equals e. So I have this b. I suppose I could do this in two ways. I could say b inverse b x equals b inverse e, so that goes away. I can do it again with this b, x equals, now I have b inverse, another b inverse there, from this b inverse, and I have the fact that I now have this b inverse squared, and that's actually just the b squared, it's inverse. But just to remind yourself that we are not dealing with just placeholders, these are not mathematical variables, and they are not placeholders just for numbers. Let's have a look at another one. Now, let's have a look then at this one. I have x squared a equals b x c inverse and a c x equals x a c. I've got to solve them simultaneously, not through normal algebra. Let's just see what we can do here. Let's see, I can do a b x there, and you just have to look at these and start playing. Quite a bit of fun to do. So let's put a c there. So I'm going to have x squared a c equals bx, because if I put a c at there, c inverse c, that gives me the identity element. And what I could do here is I could have an x, I could have an ac inverse, because I put an ac inverse in the front, associativity, xac. I can put a b there, and I can put a b there. So I have bx and I have bx. At least we have that. So we have at the moment x squared ac, and bx and bx, that's the same, so that's going to be b ac inverse xac. Immediately I see I have the ac here and ac here, so I could do this ac associativity and the ac inverse, which is just going to give me an e. And if I do exact same thing there, of course, I'm just going to be left with ac inverse x on that side. So what I have here essentially is x and an x, and that equals b. Let me make some more space because you can clearly see where this is going, that it's going to be b ac inverse x. And what I can do here is an x inverse on both sides, x inverse on both sides, and that's identity element, so I'm left with x equals, that's b, and I have ac inverse. Done and dusted. These are really a lot of fun. Really look them up, as I said, try to get some online in your textbook and try to do some of them. Just to remind yourself that this is not simple algebra anymore. We are talking about a group, set of elements, and then the operation on those elements. And it is a group, so we are dealing with those properties.